Hello, this is Ankit Reddy. Welcome to the .NET course on Educators.com, world's best online training tutorial for the leading technologies. In this video, we learn about XML concepts. What XML stands for and why is XML an example with XML? XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. And why do we use this XML is to store some data in XML files. In this video, we'll discuss about using an XML file to store some data in that XML file. Let me take an example from ASP.NET. Add rotator control is used to display random ads. The ads information can be stored in this XML file. Okay, let us flip to Visual Studio. There we'll take an example for this storing the data in XML file. For that, I'll be taking add rotator control from ASP.NET toolbox. It will be used for displaying this random ads. So when you create a fresh application, it will look like this. I have just given a name as XML concept. So first and foremost thing, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add XML file. Click on new item. Go to general or data. XML file you can see. Click on add. By default, it will be showing like this. Now we wanted to store some data inside this XML file. So XML is used to store some data. We take advertisements. See, XML is user-friendly, tags will be there. Whatever tag you want, you can take it. Suppose if I want to take educators, it will take. So the same flexibility is not there with the HTML. In HTML, we can be used in a specified, I mean predefined tags only. We cannot use whatever tag we want just like this. Remember that there is a flexibility with XML. Now let me take add inside this, and we have some properties for this XML file attributes. Image URL, let me take an image, and let me take another URL attributes called navigate URL. First, let me start with image URL. Image URL. So all the attributes will be given in a starting tag. This we discussed about HTML. Please watch HTML sessions from educators.com website. You'll be understanding that what is the attribute, why we are calling in a left, I mean the opening tag only. Here. Image URL will be there, and one more thing is navigate URL. Navigate URL. And one more thing is alternative text. I'll explain it. What are those? Why I'm keeping like these things? Then impressions. It will be like this. For this, we need an image folder. So let me create an images folder, add new folder, images. So I'm going to show three ads on our web page. So let me take some examples of web pages. I mean, I have taken three images. Whenever user clicking on that images, will be displaying the particular website. Click on paste. Now I have added. Paste. One is Google website, another is YouTube website, another one is educators.com website. First, let us see that one by one. Let me use tilt operator. This tilt operator means the images are there within this main folder, the project folder. Under this, we'll be taking images slash whatever you want, educators.com png. Dot png. Then this image URL is the URL of the image to display. So you'll be seeing this educators.png on a website. This one, please make sure that spelling mistakes are not there. otherwise it cannot be displayed. And why we use this navigate URLs will be, suppose a user clicking on this PNG, then we'll be navigating to the particular URL. When I clicking on this image, then I will be taking you to the particular URL. I wanted to take you this educators.com website. Now, what is this alternative text is called? Just now I told that please make sure that there is no spelling mistakes are there. If at all, if you have some spelling mistakes in that, otherwise typo mistakes, whatever it called. Here we'll be showing that alternative text. The text to use if the image is missing also. Suppose image is not there or spelling mistakes is not is there. So we'll be giving some alternative text. Please visit same thing this website. Then one more thing called impressions. Let me take 10 as impression, save it. Like this, I'm going to take 3 ads here. Let me take Google. This is what here, Google, YouTube. Next is YouTube. Same, make sure that everything is same. Then we know that Google site in Google. Then come to here, change accordingly, youtube.com. And here also change it. So what it means is image URL is there to display an image, and whenever you clicking on that image will be navigating to this URL. And suppose whenever you are missing this, any type mistakes are there, any image is missing, then we'll be showing alternative text. And impressions, you'll get understand what it means. Now, to display these ads, we need a web page. So that let me take the web page. Now let me add a ad rotator control here. Advertisement file is equals to the one we have XML file. Understand? That's it. Let me execute it. See this, by default educators.com image you are seeing. If I refresh it, it will be changing YouTube now, again google.com, again HTML, educators, again Google, again educators, then you'll be seeing YouTube just now. See, it will be changing. This is like whenever you have a web application and it get famous, then you can attract web address, advertisements on your application, so that you will be earning more money also from these advertisements. So we have created image folder, there we have added 3 images, and we are getting these images on our web application randomly. How we are getting randomly? Because of this ad rotator. Now if you observe this, when I'm going clicking on this, most of the times we are seeing educators.com. That is because we have made like that impressions, that one 80 we gave that educators.com. Suppose if I make it as 10, then this I'm taking 80. Now let me execute it. Earlier time we were getting educators.com more times, and now what I did is I made impression 80 for the google.com website. Now let me keep on refreshing. You'll be getting Google more times now. See, Google will be getting more times. Then YouTube will be getting least, will be having YouTube, educators.com, because impressions we have made like that. The number which is more, the likelihood of this getting advertisement will be more. And let us clicking on this, what will happen? It is going to the particular Google website. Then let me refresh YouTube. Again, it is going to the youtube.com. Then let me refresh. So clicking on educators.com website, it is going to this website. Understand? Sometimes we wanted to open this advertisement in separate file instead of opening in a same page. What I am telling is, let me go back. Here, when I clicking on this educators, here only it is getting changed. What I need is, when I clicking on this, like this, it should come. Though I am clicking on a single click or without using right click, when I clicking on this one, it should display in a separate window. For that, what we can do is, target is equals to blank. Now, let us execute this. See this. The page is still there and it is opening in a separate window. When I clicking on YouTube, the page is still there and it is opening in a separate window. Same for educators.com also. Click this. It will be coming in a separate window. Hope you understand this. This will be like this. Like this, we can use this XML concept. XML is there to use, to store some data in our XML files, and we are storing this data regarding this advertisements. We kept store here and we are displaying in a web page randomly using add rotator control. Thank you for watching. We'll meet it again for the next video session.